Where do they do that?
Oh. I'm sorry, I didn't.
Penalty flag, she says. What do you say, Richard?
Well, we were in the same thought, because I had sport. Penalty box.
In hockey, right. Well, Laura, you're up to $9,000, so let's welcome a new player now, Maureen Farrell. Hello, Maureen.
Hello. Hi.
We welcome you. Just throw it in here, Jane. Would you tell us the story of your life in 8 or 12 seconds? Thank you.
Well, I'm a new bride of about 7 weeks.
Really?
I married a man that I dated off and on for 17 years. Yes? And I'm in business for myself.
Really? What do you do?
I'm a temporary secretary.
I see. Mm-hmm. 17 years,
yes.
Eh?
Yes.
Who couldn't make up his or her mind?
We couldn't.
17 years,
uh-huh.
On and off.
Yes.
Well, I'm very happy for you.
Oh, yes, so am I. Finally.
Congratulations to him for getting you.
Oh, thank you.
All right, Maureen, you may have A or B.
I'll have B.
Okay, this is it.
I just have a question from that last board. What is Uncle Charlie? What does that mean?
Uncle Charlie. My Three Sons.
Oh, yeah,
that old series. Yeah.
Oh,
remember?
Obviously more well known than
Fred McMurray's
William Denver.
Father. Yeah, right.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Ready? The customer at the Playboy Club said, am I talking too loud for you up there?
Well, he makes me mad. I said William Frawley played Uncle Charlie, and he said,
no,
Uncle Charlie.
He just said William Demarest.
It's William Demarest.
Oh. Yes. But the thing, the whole idea is, you
and
see...
Vincent Price was not the flaw.
Listen.
David Hedison.
No, the whole idea here is, when I am speaking, it would help a little if no one else up here is speaking at the same time.
You've been off since the knot didn't come out orange. I was in the dressing room, and your valet, Dayton, said, make sure the knot comes out orange, and it came out 60 blue, 20 yellow, and hardly any orange.
There's quite a bit of orange.
Can't win with you were saying.
You were saying?
I was saying, at the customer at the Playboy Club said, that bunny is so fat.
Oh, I got it.
Good.
From the top. Good girl.
Okay.
Ha ha.
Ha ha. Here we go. Maureen Farrell. The customer at the Playboy Club said, that bunny is so fat, she doesn't look like a bunny. She looks like a blank with a cottontail.
Elephant.
Elephant. All right, anything big would be appropriate. Elephant, she said.
Elephant is close, but she's wrong. Unfortunately, the answer is hippo.
Hippo. Right. All right, Brett.
William Demarest replaced William Frawley in My Three Sons.
Is she right?
She's right. When she's right, she's right, which is so seldom. Elephant.
Elephant. All right.
How could I know what happens when I'm in kindergarten?
Ha! You wish.
Elephant.
All right. There's another one. That's two for Maureen. That bunny is so fat, she doesn't look like a Playboy bunny. She looks like a... elephant with a cottontail. What do you say to that, Helene?
Well, I was going to say those things, but I went back to my old, good old answer, which is house.
Yes.
Didn't work last time either, but I thought I'd try again. Don't get violent.
No, I will.
Thank you. Christmas on Buzzer.
Now, we're ready to carry on here. Another half of round one. Laurie, this is your question. Everyone plays. Charles Nelson Reilly said... Last week was really terrible. It was so bad. It was bad enough I had to go to the hospital, but I had to share a room with blank. Give us the reading.
Got it.
Reading, okay. All right. Laurie, Charles Nelson Reilly said last week was really terrible. It was bad enough I had to go to the hospital, but I had to share a room with blank.
Brett.
Neither one of them liked it.
I love to be with you. You know that. We've been at each other's homes. We go out. But don't ever take a six-hour flight at night to Boston sitting there.
And achieve a tie. So there you go.
I'll have B.
B. All right. Let's see how it goes.
Somebody's clicking.
Bottom row.
What is that? Wait a minute. What's that noise?
Something.
Oh, they're stapling something? What are you doing? Jack, are you back here? No, he's not there. I thought I heard a noise.
It's a quick, so easy saute and simmers to perfection, Rice-A-Roni to San Francisco Treats. And a radio, and a supply of Baskin-Robbins ice cream.
We pulled a bunch of people in this room. We said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank wreck, W-R-E-C-K. If you match the answer they gave us most often, you get $500. If you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. For matching the third most popular answer, you get a total of $100. Now.
Richard.
Ship.
Wreck.
Brett? I have one I want to use so bad. What Charles is, an old wreck.
New Orleans jazz. All right. She says New Orleans jazz will match you for the 5,000, Richard.
You never know how close we are. Dixieland.
Dixieland. Yeah. Yeah, you were in the same
idea. That's exactly
what it is. $1,000. Now, you had one shot at it and didn't do too well. Now, let's see how you do this time, right after we do this message just for you. $1,000 now. Here it is, Francis. Not too long ago, we had a bunch of people in this very room, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Twist blank. Now, the answer they wrote down most frequently is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the second most popular answer, you get $250, and then $100 for you for matching the third most popular, and three of our six ding-a-lings will help you. And there's one for you.
Betty.
If I'm going to make a fool of myself, you'll I say, all right. twist of the wrist.
Twist of the wrist, yes.
And Charles.
Charles, have you got one? Third position is tough, but there may be one that comes to your mind.
It's Twist-O-Rama, I used to go every Saturday night.
Think it over, Charles.
Twist of fate.
Twist of fate. All right. Twist of fate, twister, twist of the wrist. Now, you think it over, Francis, and choose one of those or reject all three and give us one of your own. Now,
sweetheart.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Isn't that romantic?
Yeah, and he's out there rooting for me, I
hope.
Is
he in the rooting section?
Yeah.
Good.
And I'm a native Californian.
Aren't too many of those, are there?
No, uh-uh. My parents are, too.
Really?
Yes.
Where do they live?
In Woodland Hills.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And I'm a waitress.
Where? Somewhere around here?
In a French cafe in Woodland Hills.
Okay.
I live there, too.
Well, Tanis, we welcome you and wish you the best of luck. Ladies, we'll begin by asking you, Tanis, to make your selection here. You may have A or B.
B, please.
B it is. Here it is.
Gotcha.
102-year-old Mrs. Periwinkle is really strange. I'll tell you. At night, she has two glasses of water. One to keep her teeth in, and another to keep her blanks in.
Oh, I love this one.
You like this one?
Yeah.
This is one of your faves?
Yeah. Yeah.
One to keep her teeth in, and another to keep her blanks in. She's really strange.
She's really strange. Here,
strange.
Take this to the cashier, you'll get the trash.
Tannis, honey.
More time. I would have
come on now, show it to her.
Actually, this was kind of a steal from Joe. I said Rice Krispies.
Yeah. It
would
sure
you
was.
Guess that I got that elsewhere?
Yes.
In keeping
you.
In keeping with the whole day.
That would be terrible. But you see, all of you lost sight of the fact that the question says last night, instead of eggs, she served me soft boiled.
Well, I didn't get it either then.
You didn't get it either?
Cereal. I'm with them. Yeah. They copied from me.
Oh. They did. Yes.
I have that as my answer, but he had a chance to copy my answer. He looked blatantly.
I would not copy it.
And rejected
it. You'll see why.
No. Football.
Oh. So
do you
logical.
See why?
Yeah, because see, it looks like an egg. Yes. Yeah. Not that. Well, mine was eggs, soft boiled eggs.
Yeah.
Right? Now, what do you usually have with eggs?
Bacon. Bacon.
Wouldn't it be terrible to serve? Salt, a little bit of a lift off, not
little
much,
class.
Just a little. Yes?
It's all in the eye of the beholder, right? I said a kangaroo.
A kangaroo?
Aww. Well, it's logical.
That'd get you off the ground a little bit there. So you picked up two there, and that's now you stand by because your job is to match two to tie and three to win. Now this for you.
Up next, even Rudolph can't outshine the fabulous Betty. It's more Betty Wonderful Fun as Buzzer's Betty White Christmas Match Game Marathon continues. Stay tuned.
Chef right at your side. And a snack tray and a supply of FFB Stone Wheat Wafers. Crispy, crunchy cracker squares. Tastes a little nutty, you'll agree. Stone Wheat Wafers when you're counting on good count on FFB. And a crock pot and a supply of Southern Style dinner fixes from Red and White Foods. Red and White Foods, the quality brands in nutritious economy and delightful dining. And a waffle grill and a supply of Staley syrup. 100% natural syrup. No preservatives, nothing artificial. Staley syrup, a rich country breakfast flavor that's naturally delicious. And more matches now with Gene Raymond.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Here we go. Finish this game now, Francis Patrick. Two to tie and three to win. Everyone plays again. The great...
You're always worried that Joe is going to mispronounce his own name. Joe Garage.
We had... What'd you say, honey?
To... fly through a hoop.
Fly through a hoop. Tennis...
Yes.
I thought you were going to go down the drain here. But I think she just did herself in with that answer. Now, hold on here, Francis. You need two to tie and three to win. I don't know how many flies we're going to get here, but we'll find out right now. Joe?
It's an Italian dog, right?
Yes.
That dog can tinkle through that hoop.
Tinkle through that hoop. Yes.
That's a tinkle.
Yeah, that's two of those. Okay, Chuck.
No, Joe got it wrong. The train.
Friends in the world of sports and bring some of those wonderful guys.
They watch it all the time.
Good.
And they'll be glad to come on. All even right. Bring their bubblegum cards.
We're going to pick your brains and do that. Gene Rabinier, join us next time for Match Game 78. Goodbye. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Deborah Lee Scott, Nipsey Russell, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, Johnny O. Thank you, friends, for joining us here. I greet you one and all. Howdy-do.
Howdy-do.
Now, what's going on out here? I've heard strange noises and screams and all kinds of stuff.
Oh, there was carrying on. Oh. No, I was just explaining.
Those definitions.
No, well, I was explaining to the audience. You see, I may not be Richard Dawson. He's a handsome man, but I show up better on television because I got a deeper tan.
Deeper. Okay, what do you say we greet our two players here, Cheryl Crisp and Tina Ruggiero? Okay. Now, Cheryl's the current champ. She has $350 to her credit. We've started this game. We're in the middle of round two, right? And the score at this moment is 1-0 in favor of Tina. That puts you in the catbird's...
For a very small select group. Not so select.
Nanook the Eskimo said, I'm tired of these freezing winters. I mean, have you ever tried to blank at 40 below?
Have you ever tried to get a suntan?
Oh. A suntan?
You come over here and sit with me, Cheryl.
Okay.
I think you just blew it.
I think I did, too.
I think that's a wonderful answer.
Well, I mean, it's difficult to get a suntan at 40 below, but that's not the thing that would immediately come to my mind. What would you say?
Well, I thought it might be.
Well, Cheryl, I'm glad you're leaving with some money. You've got $350 and our best wishes.
Thank you.
There she goes, Cheryl Crisp. Bye. Well, let's have a go at it here. There's the big wheel. And there's our big star wheel. It's all... Another one.
How about Nipsey?
Nipsey?
How about Camel Hump?
Camel Hump. Now, you have Camel City, Arizona, and also the back of a camel. May we see the $250 number?
There we go! Rest the kids all the time.
Very good.
I don't
okay.
know.
All right, last chance for Camel's cigarette. Slide it, Ari! Yay!
Very good.
Oh, what a wonderful winner. Congratulations to you. You now have $600 total. However, we love your enthusiasm. Pow! You have a chance to play for 10 times the amount you've just won. The least you could be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, if you'll come into my dressing room here, why, we'll have a spin of the star wheel to determine which star you'll be playing with and for how much. Now, you watch that double sign. You see, whenever this little pointer is anywhere within that area, that light lights up. It's all electronically hooked up. That means you'll be playing for $10,000 instead of $5,000. Wow. Give it a good spin there. Here we go. All right. There it is. Okay, $5,000 with Charles. That's not bad. He's a good player. We'll find out how you do with that now. Good luck to you, Tina. This is it, Chuck.
Yo!
Oh-ho. Blank.
He just made me deaf.
No, here it is. Blank drummer. Blank drummer. D-R-U-M-M-E-R. Blank drummer. Take a look at it. Drummer. Blank drummer. Ready, Chuck?
Coming. All right, I see. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yes. All right, he's ready, Tina. Give us the answer that he's put on the card. We give you $5,000, blank drummer.
I really don't have an answer. Toy drummer, and I don't know why it came to my mind. I really don't have one. It's terrible.
It's a very
hard
one.
Come think of something. I don't have one.
You could not think of it.
I couldn't think of anything.
You couldn't think of...
I kept thinking of, like, toy drummer.
March to a different drummer or...
Yeah, but...
Bass drummer.
Or any of the...
Really? Okay.
I'm
Charles,
sorry, it's always a tough one.
Bongo,
it's a tough
one. Bongo drummer would be another good one.
Oh,
that's too bad, Tina. Okay. You got your $600. You'll meet another player later. Let's all together. Now the sopranos. All right, the basses. Now all together.
Very good.
Forget it. Don't apply for the job. Watch this message, would you please?
Thank you,
darling. You're setting the panel up. Anything after this has to be good. What?
Well, even all of America couldn't. You couldn't
come on
now,
just better.
And belch.
I suppressed
Well, being a farm girl, you know, the first thing when you said bugger seeds, the first thing I thought of was udders, and I thought, well, that's ridiculous. Of course, nobody could say that, so of course I didn't. I said, though, something else. It didn't come with bucket seats, it just came with buckets.
Well, that's all. Okay, that's the answer.
That's the perfect answer.
Get out of here. She got it, Chuck. Did you get it? You don't want it.
Two zinc pails is better than buckets. You're not supposed to repeat thing.
Sure, why don't you steal it? Why repeat it?
Right. Okay, two zinc pails, and what do you got here?
Well,
I said
stools.
Seats. Stools.
You know, I figured buckets and you sit on stools. Well,
okay, got
the
idea.
The udder number.
No, she had the udder number right
the
there.
The udder number, that's...
Instead of bucket seats, it came with...
I don't know if you ever tried sitting on one. Buckets.
That's a good answer, isn't it? Okay. That's okay. If you want to say buckets, you say buckets, Betty.
Well, but as a quarter Greek myself, you see.
Comedian used to be in the... Because every night he blanks... Come on. You got it. All right. I think he's stealing your answer.
I know. Yeah. He should.
Never. In a million years.
Anytime you need help, Nipsey, just
Paul.
Okay,
I'm not
Nips.
A selfish person.
At the nightclub, Fred said, I think that comedian used to be in the Air Force. Because every night he blinks.
Bombs?
Bombs is a good answer. Perfect answer. A wonderful answer.
A marvelous answer. An absolutely fantastic answer.
Oh, atta boy, David.
Can yes. I do an imitation of this one? You ask the question. Here she is. Got it. Now watch what she got.
Oh, it's gonna
go
be
ahead. I mean,
one of her.
So well.
One of
am
her
I
lesser
exaggerating
efforts?
That one.
One of your lesser
I wish
efforts.
But the way she said, "Major heart attack
got
right
it.
Now."
Oh,
come on now, hold your card.
Tell
now.
Him the Farmerette number has been cut. You've told him all over.
No, I'm sorry. If he cut the Farmerette number, he's got to remove his hat.
What has she got?
Fly.
How cruel! Yeah, to
every,
pick
because
on
every
me.
Night he flies. Why not? If he was on something,
I
that could be it.
Got it.
Bomb. Okay.
You so hate them.
Now you must match a whole bottom tier to achieve a tie here and stay in the game. What do you got, Deborah Lee?
She matches me. Bombs.
All right. So he's now 5-3. Yes,
well,
sir.
Sitting here between Judy Garland and Mary Poppins, I thought maybe I should
there goes the umbrella.
I should be a little more positive. A good comedian never bombs. What he does is bails out.
Oh, well, that means Tina wins the game. What'd you have there?
I know!
Bomb! Your little spot there. And we'll say goodbye to Rosie. It was a pleasure
Thank
to meet you.
You.
We're going to send you a 27-year supply of rug shampoo. I mean, you're going to be so clean you won't believe it, Rosie.
Great.
Thank you for coming
Thank
by
you.
Here. Match game 78. There she goes. Rosie comes down. Now we'll spin a little commercial here, and then we'll come right back with Tina Richard. How about you? If you'd like to have June Lockhart?
Yeah. Okay. Maybe sitting in for breakfast.
She plays
day.
My mother in it. June Lockhart would be wonderful.
I saw that.
That's not what we had in mind, Charles.
Oh.
Anyway, what kind of part do you play in this?
A little young sex kitten. Gee, I don't know why.
A young sex kitten. Yeah. Oh, now we're
Animal
hurrying up.
Lover
the
that
first
I am.
She says, take your time. Now hurry
yes,
up already. Okay, join us next time. Match Game 78.
Get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Deborah Lee Scott, Nipsey Russell, and Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rivers.
All right. Are you ready out there?
Yeah.
Are you ready up here?
Ready on the right.
Terrific.
Stunning.
We lost. Oh, thank you very much.
I'll keep them informed on the scores as the show progresses.
Oh, all right. We lost 9-2.
Bender is bored. Bender is bored. Bender.
Wheel up. Bender's bothering me. Bender,
driver distraction detected.
Oh, justice team.
Captain Yesterday.
Clubberella.
And Super King, the best one of the three. Wow.
Go, go, new Justice Team. Go, team, go, team, 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 team. Who's the newest Justice Team? The new Justice Team. Captain Yesterday is fast. Also, he is from the past. Not just fast, but from the past. Captain Yesterday. Super King has all the powers of a king, plus all the powers of Superman. Also, he's a robot. Ain't it cool? Super King, you rule. Clubberella beats you up. Clubberella beats you up. Who does she beat up? You! Clubberella! Citizens, never fear. Crazy do-good freaks are here until they run out of steam. Miracle Cream, gives the power to the team. Its effects wear off for sure, so they just swap on some more. The new Justice Team!
Ta-da!
The new Justice Team!
It's beautiful. I'm glad global warming never happened.
Actually, it did. But thank God nuclear winter canceled it out.
Hi.
Enough of your mindless chit-chat. Let's get going.
Jaw dummit, we're stuck.
At least you're not cold at least you're not cold blooded.
Look out! We're heading straight for those trees!
Yeah, relax. Trees down!
Trees down!
Cool. Hey, what do you do if you want the trees up?
Trees up!
Trees down!
Trees down!
Oh! Looking good, people!
Excuse me, sir. You're snowboarding off the trail.
Lick my frozen metal ass.
You, a bobsledder? That I'd like to see.
Listen, you filthy crab. 1,000 years ago, there was a legendary team of Jamaican bobsledders.
Yep, I remember. They came in last at the Olympics, then retired to promote alcoholic beverages.
A true inspiration for the children. A little help, please. No!
Oh, what the hell?
Why do you do this to me?
Come on, you know I can't do it.
Yes, you can.
That's good.
Not a bad idea at all there. What do you say?
Well, this is part of the leg, actually. If you go, if the leg counts from the bottom of the sole to the hip.
Pity pat, standing pat. You want one of those, or do you want one of your own?
Let's say love pat.
Let's say love pat. Okay. What do you think's under the big one?
Down pat.
Down pat? You got it down pat.
No,
all right, slide it.
Standing pat.
And a boy, Nipsey.
Listen to me.
All right, now you're up to $350 total amount. However, the amount you just won is $250. That means when we play the big game here, when we spin that star wheel, the least you could be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. However, we ain't going to do that now. We're going to do this now.
John. How are you?
Love your entrance.
Oh, you're okay. Are you okay? Good. Are you okay?
We're okay.
Yeah. I'm okay. You're okay.
Oh, careful.
Oh, careful. I almost tripped on the cable there.
Is that cute? That's new. It's Glenn Plaid.
Yes. Oh, I'm going to revive it single-handedly.
Yeah.
All right. Shall we have a go at it?
Why not?
Here's the champ, Kevin Dickerson.
I sure am.
Yes, I am. He says he's ready. Now, here's the way it is. He's won... Jungle department store and buy black loincloth because Tarzan get job as blank.
Well, I can only think of one thing.
Okay, here we go, Lisa Henderson. Tarzan have to go to jungle department store and buy black loincloth because Tarzan just get job as blank.
Usher.
Usher. Ushers wear black?
I think, cruel.
Yeah. They're cruel.
Yeah.
Oh, we're nice, though.
Turn on you.
Yeah, right. Okay, she said usher because she thinks ushers wear black.
Anything is better than mine.
You're not going to believe it.
I think that was a good one.
I tell he wears black, doesn't he?
Yes,
and
he does.
All bears
any
do
club
wear
where
black.
I work, yes. He does.
I see. All right. And you?
And Undertakers.
Undertakers and Paul Bears. All those people wear black. All right, Nipsey, what came to your mind?
An usher at the funeral.
Okay. They're trying for you, Lisa.
Yeah.
Okay, Miss Betty, honey.
A swinging undertaker.
A swinging undertaker. Yeah. So there's one patron question. Now this. Don't think my girlfriend likes me anymore.
My girlfriend doesn't like me anymore.
Right. When we first met, she blew up my photo. Last night, she blew up my blank. Here we go, Kevin Dickerson. Larry said, I don't think my girlfriend likes me anymore. When we first met, she blew up my photo. Last night, she blew up my blank.
Car.
Car's good. Cars go up in flames occasionally, don't they?
Well, we were on the right track. I got him out of the car and into the house.
All right, that's a good one. That's a good one.
Oh, honey,
when he does a good one, I have to tell him it's a good one.
Yes, I don't know.
I get tired of saying it's a rotten one all the time.
Well, it don't do no good to tell him it's good, because next time he goes right back to where he was before.
Oh, I see. Yeah, well, that was a rotten one.
Oh, thank you.
Even though it was a good one. No, that was a good one. I'm only kidding. What?
Well, car's awful good.
Yes.
But I got him right into the house.
Into the house, too. Two houses there. Chuck?
Yo! Right.
Oh.
Now listen,
take that
Chuck is a guy up there, and you're the girl. Okay, do you understand that, lady?
My jacket's so butch, I've forgotten.
Okay.
Boy, it's unbelievable, isn't it? It's not car. I'm sorry, Kevin. It's Mazda.
Oh. All together.
Okay. Boom diddy boom diddy boom man.
Yeah.
This couldn't be for $5,000 again, could it? Because I matched him, car.
Oh, car. All right, he's up to two now. What do you got for him?
Out of the car, into the house, sitting at the table, she blew up his dinner.
Now, Miss Betty.
Car.
Car. 3 for Kevin on the first round. Pretty tough going there. Better catch up, Lisa.
I'll try A this time.
A it is for Lisa. She's got a little catching up to do. Herb said, I've heard of no-frills flights, but this is ridiculous. During the whole flight, I had to sit on my blank. I've heard of no-frills flights, but this is ridiculous. During the whole flight, I had to sit on my blank.
No-frills.
Okay, right. This is ridiculous. Yeah.
Oh, I just terrible.
Yeah, excellent.
It must be a real bummer.
No, he's looking at his. Okay, everybody ready? Here we go. Lisa Henderson. Now, think about this carefully before you respond. Herb said, I've heard of no-frills flights. What? This is ridiculous. During the whole flight, I had to sit on my blank.
Luggage?
Luggage is a perfect answer. Isn't that good? I think luggage is excellent. They like it. You like it.
I liked it. I like it. I had the carry-on bag.
Well, that's luggage. There's one.
Well, now, you have to think about this because this very often can be a bag or luggage or something. Wife.
Oh.
And a pretty little baggie she was,
yes,
too.
Yes, a very little baggie. Why, sir? Yes, sir?
Confucius say you talk a lot and answer wrong. An American luggager attaché overnight case.
That's it. Okay. You got two, Lisa. Deborah Lee, do you make it 3 for Lisa?
No,
why?
I said wife.
Oh, all
I
right.
I meant Brett.
Okay, it's two wives and two luggages. What do you got there?
Well, see, as a weary traveler, maybe I'm concentrating on you. Well, you said no frills.
Flight, no frills,
which
right.
means you get nothing but a... During the whole flight, I had to sit on my lunch.
Okay.
He must be hungry. Keeps
yes.
thinking about
That's
food.
Right.
No, they don't give any food on a no-frills flight.
Yes, and no seats either. That's
I'm
why
blushing,
they sit on the
folks.
Luggage there. Oh, you're blushing now?
I am.
Glad you told us. Hard to tell. Yeah. All right.
This is such a fun game, and this is when it gets to be the most fun
yes.
is when it's up to me to match
right.
or make or break, right?
That's right. If she doesn't match you, out she goes.
Wives or luggage, they... I said a wife.
Wife! So there it is. That means Kevin wins the game.
Two hours later.
You're watching a Betty White Christmas on Buzzer.
Hey, Johnny. Matching the most popular, you get $500. For matching the second most popular, $250, and then for matching the third, $100, and we are going to help you.
Deborah Lee.
Adam's Apple.
Adam's Apple.
Brett.
Brett.
Adam's Rib.
Adam's Rib.
We're still
Nipsey.
Today.
Nipsey. Third is a tough position, so think about it for a second.
Yeah, I was thinking about his old lady, so let me see. Adam's Eve.
Adam's Eve.
Yes, that's who got him in trouble.
That's the night before Adam.
That's the night before, okay. Adam's Eve, Adam's Apple, and Adam's Rib are the three. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Adam's Apple.
Adam's Apple is what we want. Let's go over there and find out if it's under the $100 number. Adam's Family.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
Well, that was spelled with two D's, wasn't it? The Adam's Family.
Cain and Abel.
TV
little...
May we see the $250 number? Adam's
this
Rib.
Oh, gotta be the apple.
Pretty good for the...
I get kisses if I win and lose.
That's right. Terrific, Deborah Lee. Okay, now you got the $500. Again, Kevin, it means the least to play for is 10 times that amount or 5,000. However, you can double it and play for $10,000.
Oh, baby.
If you have a lucky spin of the star wheel here to find out which one you'll be playing with and for how much, give it a go. There it is.
Come on, sweetness. Let's,
let's
get a double.
If that blue light stays on,
oh,
it'll be double.
No,
and
no,
it looks like we're going to make it. Ho, ho, ho. Are you ready?
No.
Yes.
Yes.
$10,000. And Betty White, here we go.
3 hours later.
Colleen Callahan. Hello there. Get right back up there now. And we'll welcome Colleen. And know where you're from.
Well, I did.
Where?
Rolling Fork, Mississippi.
Mississippi?
Mm-hmm.
You vacationing here?
Yes.
Having a good time?
Terrific.
You married?
No.
That's why she's having such a good time.
We're going to quit on that winning note here now, and you ask both of you to stand by, and we're going to do a little business with America, right? No, oh, we're not going to cut. Don't stop the music. No. Well, I thought I got a hurry-up signal because we had a commercial coming. All right, Colleen, you got A or B here?
A.
A it is. All right. Norm said.
Start the music.
I went to a very strange Italian wedding. What a mess. Instead of throwing rice, they threw blank. That's close enough.
Not right.
Well, show them how to spell it.
How do you spell it?
That's sweet. Okay. Spelling doesn't count here. We'll figure it out somehow. Don't worry about it.
Sweet.
Colleen.
Yes.
Norm said I went to a very strange Italian wedding, and what a mess. Instead of throwing rice, they threw blank.
Da spaghetti.
What's that?
Da spaghetti.
Spaghetti. They threw spaghetti? Well, I don't think spaghetti would be as messy as some other things, because just plain spaghetti.
I thought pizzas instead of...
Pizza. Yeah, pizzas, you see, would have tomatoes and anchovies and all that stuff in it. That would make a mess.
Oh, honey, it was all cooked and stringy and everything spaghetti.
Oh! Wet spaghetti. Yeah.
I wish we had some Julia Child.
Oh, I wish you could get the line straight and try and get the laugh.
And then we could throw some spaghetti and meatballs on that suit and see how stainy it can get.
What do you got for us, Deborah Lee?
I got the spaghetti.
You got a spaghetti. That's three for her. Little spaghetti there for the lady?
It looked like linguine, but it really was spaghetti.
Spaghetti, okay. Four for her. Now what?
I don't want to open another whole can of worms here. I said spaghetti.
Okay. So she did very well with her first round question. Most unusual. Now we've got a commercial for you, so pay attention. Listen, you were all a splendid bunch, especially the funny hat.
Head, you were right.
Thank you all. We'll join us next time for Match Game 78. I'm Gene Mayburn. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. This program was edited for broadcast.
6.5 hours later.
Right, there they are. Winning money today for the red section from Laverne and Shirley, Mr. Eddie Mecca and his gal, actress Shirley Kirks. Oh, yes. We have a hot group today, don't we, huh?
Wow. Yeah,
isn't this marvelous. Terrific?
I think the yellows are the loudest.
You do,
no,
eh?
I think the blues are.
I'm not sure. No, it's not. It's not really that the yellows are the loudest. They're the meanest is what they are.
Don't believe anybody that's the host of the Liars Club.
That's true. Eddie, welcome to you. It's nice to have you with us.
Thank you for
having me. Rookies on a show. And Shirley, it's terrific to see you again.
Thank you.
And I worked together a year ago where we did a variety show.
What? The first time Shirley and I met was on your show. I was sitting in the audience and she was on stage and boing, that was it.
Is that right?
Ever since then, it was...
No, oh, well, you treat her nice, so you have to answer to me, sir. Here we go. The first question is worth $150. It is for the ladies of our panel. Ladies, you're staying at a hotel in the desert, and you're up on the 10th floor. There's no other building to be seen for miles, and nobody can see into your room. Now, when you get undressed at night, would you still pull down the shades? Yes or no? That's very simple, isn't it? You're out in the desert, you're at a hotel, up on the 10th floor, nobody can see you, there's no buildings around, nothing. And you're in your room, when you get undressed at night, would you still pull down the shades? Yes or no? That's very simple. Goodbye, ladies, think it over. Oh. We're talking about habit, we're talking about all those things, I guess. Jamie, what would Joy, in a case like that, would she still pull down the shades?
I tell you, Joy is very bold and brazen. She's been known to skinny dip around the swimming pool that we have. However, she is prudish at times. If I were in the room at the time, I think she would pull the shades. But
if you were in the room,
yes,
she'd pull the shades?
Yes, she would, because nobody would want to see what I look like.
Yeah.
including Joy. She'd send me out of the room, then pull the shade. I think that it's a very difficult question because she...
1 eternity later. 75 years later. 2,000 years later.
Close them.
She'll pull them down.
Yes.
The bananas agree. It's always nice to have them on your side, and even when you're wrong, you know.
Yeah, they won't always be there.
You can't see anything, and nobody can see into the room. When you get undressed at night, will you pull down the shade still?
You know, it's a hard one because you could argue on both sides. With all those... If it's a beautiful night, all those stars around, you know, Frank Sinatra, Bert Convy... I think I probably still would, yeah.
That's what the man said.
Oh! You got out of that one, Alan.
But I knew she'd be interested in what was on looking at the outside, too.
Well, sure, it's the desert, it's night, and it's very pretty. But you never know, right? Some poor slob hitchhiking across the desert could think it was a mirage, wouldn't he? Look at that!
Or a nightmare.
Okay, Eddie, what's Shirley going to say to this?
My papa was a priest, so it's very hard for me to answer this, but...
What?
My papa was a priest, so it's hard for me to answer this question without giving myself...
Your
father was a priest?
No, my papa. That's my grandfather.
Oh, your papa was...
My father was a reverend, I'm sorry. My papa was a priest. Anyways, I think Shirley is kind of shy, I think.
I missed something here. No, don't... Do you want to explain that any further, or should we just let
that
go?
Yeah, I'll explain. I think she'll draw the curtains.
That's a perfect explanation, isn't it?
She'll close the curtains.
She'll draw the curtains. Okay, here she comes.
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting, and they had to hire a new one.
I think she will say, Well, we were playing tennis one time with a specific couple, and they were he was from the Chicago Bears, and he was serving really fast, and she asked him to slow it down, and we got into a big fight, and she stepped in the middle, and I think she was very sorry for it.
Who got in the fight? The other couple?
Actually, him and I did, but she stepped in the middle of it. So I think she's
And saved your life, no doubt.
Well, not really, because I got it. So I think she was sorry.
Because you got it?
Yeah.
You mean he hit you?
No, he was close to it.
He really was, eh?
Yeah.
Who was it?
I don't really want to say.
Well, let's see. Anybody?
Dick Gordon. No, I didn't want to say.
Is that who it was?
Yeah.
From the Chicago Bears, eh?
Yeah.
He was serving fast to you.
No, for her, at her.
At and her, and you stepped
slow
in?
Slow it down, and he said he started lobbing the ball, and we started fighting, and then, you know, him and I got into an argument, and like this, and, you know, I think she was sorry she stepped in the middle of it.
So
I could have taken him. I had a chance, you know.
But yeah, you had a chance. What the heck? How big was he?
He was about 6'5", and about 250 pounds. Yeah. I was glad she stepped in.
Well, how much do you weigh, Eddie?
I 150.
Yeah. He only had you by 100 pounds.
5'5", 150. It's not very
You had a challenge, but a very little one.
Yeah, probably why Shirley stepped in. We've changed places after halftime. I have three lovely ladies with me, and one in particular I would like to address this to and call your attention to something. Tonight is a very, very special night for Betty White because her show premieres tonight on CBS at 9 o'clock, right? Yes. The Betty White Show tonight. This is it.
Thank you. Thank you. I really appreciate that.
It's going to be a hit.
I tell you. I saw the pilot, and it's going to be a big hit. You don't have to worry about a thing.
Oh, Bert,
everybody watches Tattletale is going to watch it tonight, too. Don't worry about it. Now, guys, here we go. First question for you. It's worth $150. Got a good game. Anybody can win. If you could exchange singing voices with anyone, whom would you choose? That's a good question. If you could exchange singing voices with anyone, whom would you choose? Okay, goodbye. You know, they'll handle this a lot of different ways. Maybe their favorite singer, or maybe someone whose voice they think they're kind of like. Who knows? What do you think Eddie will say?
Oh, I'm pretty positive he might say Tony Bennett.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Why not?
Yeah.
If you're going to exchange, why not? He'll say Tony Bennett.
Absolutely.
He likes Tony Bennett.
Here Charles Aznavour is second, possibly,
yes.
But Tony, I think, will be first.
Okay, here he comes. Find out. Eddie, whose voice will it be if you can exchange voices, singing voices, that is?
I'd have to say Tony Bennett.
That's the one. You are hot today.
You know I'd go from rags to riches.
You're right, Eddie. Do you sing, Eddie?
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, on Laverne and Shirley, I've done a lot of takeoffs from Tony Bennett.
Yeah.
He's a beautiful singer.
There you are.
He is a beautiful singer.
Well, you're right. Thank you, Eddie.
Same Joy? Nose, too.
Same nose. What will Jamie say? Who would he pick?
This is very funny, but it's Tony Bennett, definitely.
Really?
Yes. We discussed it many times.
He hasn't got the same nose as Tony
Bennett.
No.
Okay. He never got it fixed. I think he likes that. He could have had it fixed, and he didn't.
He turned it down.
Yeah.
Okay. It's Tony Bennett. Here he comes. Hi there, big guy.
Hi.
Gee, this is terrific. You get to be Butch for a whole week. You know that, Jamie? If you could exchange...
You stay out of my dressing room, Condi.
If you could exchange singing voices with anybody, who would it be? Hello, this question's worth $300 and this will decide it. Gentlemen, anyone can win, even Alan. And
you watch your mouth.
Alan, you're not that far behind. You have $75. People have come from behind and 75 and won lots of times.
I know, I
Maybe
know.
Maybe twice in 900 shows it's happened. Men, our magic genie has a deal for you. Hoo-ha! Every week, a manicurist will come into your home and give you a manicure absolutely free. Will you take the deal, yes or no? That's it. Kind of simple.
What?
Our magic genie has a deal for you. Every week, a manicurist will come into your home and give you a manicure absolutely free. Will you take the deal? Yes or no? That's all. Goodbye. Sounds simple enough, doesn't it? Does Alan get manicures?
Well, he doesn't all the time, but if he has to handle it, he would love that. There's nothing he'd like better.
Then to have somebody come in once a week and do that. I've never done that. I've always wanted to. I never have. Wonder why.
I don't know.
Must
that's
be some deep sight. It's probably because I can't get my thumb out of my mouth. You'll say, yes,
yes,
here he comes. Alan, would you go for that deal? We're starting with... Hello, everybody. Thank you. Welcome to Satterfield. Nice to have you with us. You're going to have a good